For the first time in American history, our generation was at risk of having a shorter lifespan than our parents. And it was because of what we ate.
So we started to keep track of what we were eating. But we found we needed help making sense of our data.
So hair is a continuous recorder. It's a tape recorder of diet. And so this hamburger that becomes part of my diet will eventually find its way into my hair. I've analyzed your hair, and the real conclusion is that the carbon in your bodies is really originates from corn.
From corn.
Corn. When I'm talking about corn, I'm not talking about corn on the cob, you know, sweet corn. I'm talking about the corn that's being used as a material that's going into the foods that we use ubiquitously. The apple juices and the grape juices that are canned and they say sweet, that's gonna be a high fructose corn syrup. And then you look down the meats, beeves, porks, chickens. You feed them corn and that gets turned into their biomass that we consume. And you walk down the cookie aisle.
Corn starch, corn gluten meal,
hydrolyzed corn protein,
corn syrup, corn starch, corn syrup solid,
corn starch,
hydrolyzed corn protein,
high fructose corn syrup,
high fructose corn syrup,
corn king bacon.
For Americans that I've run the isotope analysis on, those numbers are showing this huge weight of the influence of corn.